going on, guys? Fitcho here, and welcome back to the Fitcho Career. It is part number 7, the Canadian Grand Prix. Now, I want to bring a bit of regularity to this series, so from now on, there will be a new episode of this every single Sunday, but occasionally there will be more, but that's going to be like a while down the track until there's going to be more than one a week. That will be when I'm back on school holidays, so it's like a 10-week term, and we've just finished like week 3, so it's a fair way off. So for the next 7 weeks or so, there's going to be a new episode of this every single Sunday. Now, we're going to try and build on our good form from the last two races. We got a podium in Spain and a win in Monaco. What can we do here in Canada? Now, this track isn't really going to suit our car very much as it is a power track. But we are running the lowest downforce settings possible. We are running 1-1 wings. But I really don't know how we're going to go. I haven't done much practice. I just jumped into time trial, so I don't actually know where we stand against other people. But let's just jump into this qualifying. Come on, Maldonado, give me some slipstream. Chuck it up into Rich. Go up your inside, into the bus stop. That's just bunny hop, beautifully. We're gonna come straight to the line to set our first lap. And we go P1, nope, we don't go P1. Thanks, Hamilton. Oh, and there was something I was gonna tell you guys, like, if my voice, I've spun it. I've been T-boned. Hamilton's blown up. That was a mistake. Anyway, what I was trying to say is, if my voice sounds a little weird today, that's because I went to the footy earlier today and my team sort of played terribly and I sort of spent a large portion of the game yelling. And as you can imagine, that doesn't have great effect on my voice. My voice is probably sounds a little bit weird, that is why. I should probably get out of all these cars' way and get back to the garage, so I'm not setting another lap. Screw it, I'm staying in the garage. I saved my tires. I really don't think we can go much faster because we got the slipstream and stuff down the back straight. I think that's probably the best lap I'm gonna do, so might as well sit it out in the garage and see if our position changes. And it doesn't look like it's going to. I think we have qualified on the front row here in Canada. Yes, get in! Front row star in Canada, second place on the grid. That is pretty bloody good. We're carrying on that form from the last two races. Of course, we got that podium in Spain and then that win in Monaco. And now we're on the front row here in Canada. Hopefully we can turn that into a decent race result, but let's find out. Let's get into the Canadian Grand Prix. Here we are in Canada, back on the front row again. This time it's not pole position like Monaco, but I really don't care. We are still on the front row in Canada. For a power track and a Renault engine, that is pretty bloody good. Let's have a look at the race strategy. It's going to be a one-stop here in Canada, pitting about lap 15 or 16 for the primes and going to the end for the 35-lap Canadian Grand Prix. Without further ado, let's get into the race. Here we are. Four lights, five lights, lights out and away we go. Try not to get heaps of wheel spin. We've actually got off to a pretty good launch for my standards here on F1 2015. We've only lost one position to Felipe Massa, who I've given a little bit of a tap there. But that's okay. We've lost one position off the start. But as I said, for F1 2015, that's okay. But let's push to get back up into second. We've got a bit of a run on Felipe here. Can we look to the inside? Up the inside we go, into this left-hander. We're going to run him right out of track. We lose the back end a little bit, but we pull the move off quite nicely there. And Rosberg actually capitalizes on that as well. He's now going up my outside. I'm not going to let that happen, Nico. I'm holding on to this second place. A little bit of a track extend there. I just went a little bit hot, but it is okay, and I've got a little bit away from Rosberg there. So we have held on to our second place by the hairpin, so I'm pretty happy with that. But Hamilton has got a 2 second lead already, which is not good, but let's put our head down and see if we can catch Hamilton. I'm not optimistic about our chances of catching him, because I've sort of got his teammate right behind me, which is a bit more concerning right now, but we'll see what we can do. Is, oh, we've butchered, absolutely butchered the chicane there. That was dreadful line. As now Nico's going to our outside as we head into turn number one. We're gonna run him right out of road. No chance of getting past there. Oh crap, I thought I was closer to the right hand side of the track. I was looking too much in my mirrors. But he's gone on my inside and I've held it around, right around the outside. I was a bit aggressive there, forcing him up on the curb. But that was a clean defensive maneuver and we have held on to second. Okay, Rosberg has damage to his front wing. That's interesting. I'm not sure how he got it. I don't think he just did it then, but he might have, considering when the messages come through. I hope I didn't damage his car, though. I'm not going to be able to do much to defend this time. He has the aid of DRS now, and there he goes. And we have lost second place to Rosberg, but we get a better exit than him, but he gets DRS again as they run off one detection point here in Canada. Can we launch a move down the inside of turn one? We just edge our nose in there, and the way the AI worked, oh my god, the back end. He gave us room, but I got forced onto the outside turn two and just couldn't hold it. So now I've got to push hard to try and get back past Rosberg, who has a bit of a slide. I'm all over his gearbox, making contact even, but I've just got a little bit wide on the dirty stuff, trying to hold it around his outside, and I couldn't hold it. And I've just made a bit of a mistake there, struggling to get the power down. I think that's our chance of getting Rosberg gone, to be honest. Oh my god. What a moment. I just had a huge freaking moment, and now I've got these two behind me. God, my tires aren't even that worn yet. They shouldn't be that damaged yet. Now Fernando Alonso is looking to my outside as we head down towards... Oh my god, I'm struggling to get the car stopped. Something's just... My tires are just gone. I've just lost all grip all of a sudden. I don't know what's going on right now. Squeeze him out on the apex there. I gave him enough space. Oh, the back end. What has happened to the grip levels of this tire? It's like it's hit a cliff. We're only on lap 9. Maybe the 12th lap these tires are done. An out lap of flying and an in qualifying. And 9 laps of this race. And now, okay, Alonso and Bottas, I believe it is, have fallen way back. Okay, this is really odd right now. Wait, the leaders are pitting. Hamilton and Rosberg have pit. Now I'm in the lead of the race. That's a very, very early stop here in Canada. It was only lap 9 when he came into the pits, and lap 8, I presume, for Hamilton. Okay, this is very odd. I'm not too sure what's happening. It's still another 6-7 laps or something until I'm meant to be pitting, I believe, so. Should I mirror them, or should I go on my own strategy here? Light rain arriving in 15 minutes. That's very interesting. That's probably going to be lap 25, I'm going to guess. We're going to have light rain. Okay. Maybe it would be better to pit for options, because I know the rain's coming. 10 minutes, or 10 laps, I should say, before the end. Is it going to get... I'm going to guess if it's going to get wet, then it's probably going to get wet enough to go onto some sort of wet tire. So do I go for another set of options and just hope it gets wet enough to go onto inters or wets, and I don't have to use the prime tire at all? Decisions, decisions, decisions. That could be a potentially very good strategy. assuming it gets wet enough, but I don't know if it's going to. Oh crap, Alonso's right there. I'm too busy thinking about strategy. Now I've got a Spaniard going up my inside. And I hold... Oh! These tires are going. Hamilton has just taken the lead. Hamilton? Oh, and there's Rosberg. Oh, these tires are gone. I've got to pit. I'm going to have to pit. These tires are gone. I'm just going to go onto whatever tire the team puts us on. These tires have just shat themselves. That worked. I had to try and avoid Rosberg there, but get into the pit lane as quickly as we could, and we didn't damage our front wing. That was a bit of an interesting situation, but into the pits we go for prime tires. I didn't really get a chance to change it, but all of a sudden those tires literally just shat themselves. I lost four positions very quickly there, and I've almost spun it into the pit wall, which would not be a good plan, but we're going to rejoin the race in ninth position. That has not gone well. Okay, we're gonna try and get past our teammate, and he's shut the door on us right there. It was a bit aggressive looking. Oh, I've lost traction in the rear. I am really struggling with the tires. It could partly be down to the very low downforce I'm running, but it seems worse than when I was doing time trial with these exact same downforce settings. So I'm not too sure. The tires, I'm just really struggling right now in all aspects. Getting the car stopped, especially the hairpin, the chicane, and turn one. I'm struggling with traction out of that corner and this corner up here. And I'm just struggling with a bit of understeer in general. It's a bit of a tricky car to drive right now with weird tires and low downforce. But up the inside, we go with our teammate, which is going to turn to the outside for the chicane. I've gone a bit deep. Like I was just explaining, I'm struggling to get the car stopped. But we have successfully got past our teammate up into 8th place now. Yep, there's water on the front of my car. I can see it running off. The rain is starting to come down. It's coming down a lot in this part of the circuit. Last lap right here, it was perfectly dry. It's coming down quite quickly. It's already quite visibly wet one lap later. So it's going to be interesting how much wetter it gets and how quickly it gets wetter. As I've got a little bit of a nudge there from Alonso, who's been catching me quite fast, but he is on the super softs, as you could see there. This is going to be interesting if it gets wet enough for the intermediate tires, and if it does, when to actually make the switch. It's already quite wet up here. Like I said, even here, last lap, it was perfectly dry at the hairpin. And now it is starting to get wet. We're going to push on for one more lap on these dry tires, and we're going to assess it this lap, see if it's time to change. Someone has pulled into the pit lane ahead of me, though. I reckon it's wet enough. I'm going to make the call of the inters. I usually make the call a little bit early, but I'm going to go for it again with an earlier call. I'm going to change to the intermediates, because it is getting a lot wetter very quickly, so we're going to dive straight into the pit lane to fit the intermediate tires. This could, again, be a bit early. I have a habit of making these calls to switch to wet weather tires early, but it is getting very wet very quickly here, so maybe this is the right call. Maybe by the time I get halfway around the lap, these tires are the right tire. That's how quickly it's getting wet here, so I don't know. This could be a good call. It could be a bad call. Heavy rain in 10 minutes, so it is going to get heavier. This could be the right call. Like, some parts of the track, these feel like the right tire. In other parts, they don't. So it's very interesting. I'm not too sure. I really don't know who's on which tires. Let's actually just have a quick look in the race director. Who's on which tires? And everyone looks like they're on dry tires. I am the only one on a wet weather compound. That's interesting, but to me, like right here, I can see spray coming off my own tires, and it is visibly quite wet. It looks like this should be intermediate weather, but most cars seem to be on dry tires. I'm not too sure, it doesn't make much sense to me, but we're gonna push on and see what happens. Ricciardo must be having a horrid day, down in 22nd. Whereas in real life here, back in 2014, he managed to come away with a win, so he's not having a good time, but it is looking so wet to me, and it looks like there's a lot of cars in the pits now. They are surely all making the jump over to intermediate tyres now. Let's push. Let's bunny hop and see where we can come out. There's Vettel, there's Bottas, and we come out right behind Sebastian Vettel in 6th place. Let's try and get past the German on his cold intermediate tyres. Can we look up the inside here where he made that mistake in 2011? Around his outside, yes, we get it done. A bit of a slide there, but he's coming back at us down the outside. Well, we make a little bit of contact there. And we are comfortably ahead of Vettel there. Now we've got Bottas ahead of us. It is getting very, very wet now. I think I'm going to risk it and go on to some full wet tires right now. It seems very, very wet to me. I think it's time. I might be making this call early again, but it seems like it's time for the wets to me. I just started to lose a lot of grip on that lap on the inters, and it just looks so wet. So I'm going to risk it, go with the wet tires. Hopefully this risk pays off. Oh no! Oh, I've speared straight on coming out of the pits. This is not good signs for these tires. Oh, the back end! I may have fucked up with this call. Actually, these tires are starting to come decent. I've caught Raikkonen 4 tenths in the first sector alone. These tires are starting to come good. Vettel, no Vettel. Oh, I've lost the back end. Ooh, the front wing. Oh no, I've spun it. I'm just trying to put the power down and get past Vettel, and I just put the power down a little bit too much. Probably didn't help that I just changed up into Rich to try and get past those guys. Jeff's telling me to go to inters right as everyone swapped to wets. What the fuck? Everyone's switching to wets. And Jeff just told me to switch to inters, I'm pretty sure. I am really confused right now, but I have gone and spun it, which is really not good. It's completely screwed me over. I was fighting for about 5th place with Vettel, and just got on the power a bit too much in these very tricky conditions, and around she went. Wait, Hamilton's now down to 6th. That's very odd. Someone's pissing. That was Hamilton in the pits. He must have got damage or something. Ericsson. Oh, okay, maybe shouldn't be in rich. Max. Nico Rosberg has won the race, and I just got a massive tank slapper coming out of the hairpin. And that could be my chance of getting in the top five gone. I'm gonna bunny hop it. I don't care. I've got a big gap to Raikkonen, and I could get Master if I execute the bunny hop just so. And I got a penalty. Yeah, okay, I pushed my limits a little bit. Jeff's saying it pretty... What is my wheel doing? But we have finished the Canadian Grand Prix in P6 there. I don't think the penalty is enough to knock us down to 7. After a front row start, that's pretty disappointing, to be honest. We just got caught out with the tyres. We really, really struggled with the tyres. And there you go, Nico Rosberg has won the Canadian Grand Prix from Fernando Alonso and Valtteri Bottas. Two cars we were battling with in the early stages of the race. All three cars, I should say, were battling with Rosberg as well in the early stages of the race. Then you got Sebastian Vettel, Felipe Massa, and me in sixth place. Kimi Raikkonen, Lewis Hamilton, he pitted towards the end. I don't know why. You guys hopefully will know, because I hopefully found it in the replays and showed it to you. Then Jenson Button and Sergio Perez rounding out the points. But like I just said, that after starting on the front row, starting second on the grid, that is a bit of a disappointing result. Like I said, we just struggled with the tires. We had a lot of tire wear in the early phases of the race on those options. They went off really, really quickly, and I was really struggling actually to get the car stopped. On many, many laps, I actually missed the chicane at the end of the lap. Not because I was being a twat and trying to cheat, because I just couldn't get the car stopped for the chicane, and I had to keep running deep over the sleeping policeman there. That wasn't fun. And I was finding it a bit tricky, especially into the hairpin. I was always missing the apex there. And it was a little bit understeer, and I had a bit of problems getting the power on. Then the rain came, and I made some strategy calls. Maybe I made the calls a little bit early, just because the way the wet works in this game. But it seemed to me, if it was real life, that it was definitely inters or wet conditions when I made the changes. But maybe not so in the game. I probably changed a little bit early for the game, but then I struggled a bit in the wet conditions because we were running the very low downforce. And when you have wet conditions with low downforce, it really just doesn't work too well. But let's have a look at the championship standings. We have actually fallen down to 8th as we have been jumped by Fernando and Bottas, or one of the two. I think we were 7th, so one of either Valtteri Bottas or Fernando Alonso have jumped us in the points. It would have to be Bottas looking at the points, I believe. We are now 4 points off Ricciardo and 5 points off Bottas and 1 point clear of Felipe Massa. So I reckon our target for the championship is probably going to be to finish in about 6th place. I'm not too sure if we can challenge the Ferraris, who are currently on 72 and 73 points respectively. And then of course you've got Vettel actually doing quite well, unlike real life in this season, up with 80 points. Just off Lewis Hamilton, who's struggling a bit in comparison to his teammate. A bit like this year at the moment. Speaking of this year, the Russian qualifying is on very, very soon, the Russian Grand Prix tomorrow. That will be a very interesting race, hopefully. I'm getting a little bit sidetracked. So our aim, I reckon, is going to be to finish 6, beat Bottas, Ricciardo, and Massa. And, of course, the McLarens. Originally in this series, we're talking about the Force Indias. So let's have a look at them. They are down in 12th and 14th place with 10 and 11 points, respectively, with our teammates splitting them with 11. So I think we're way past the Force Indias now. I don't think they're going to catch us this far into the season with the amount of points they have scored. So I think we have easily achieved that goal we set ourselves early in the season. Because, like I've said many times, I don't start the season strongly. So I was thinking I'd be challenging the Force Indias, but now that the European season has started, where I come on strong, like Spain, the first European race was the 3rd place, I believe. Monaco, we won. And then here, we got a front row start and then got a 6th place. So our new goal is probably going to be finished 6th in the Drivers' Championship. But if we look at the Constructors now, we are in 5th place with a lot of points either side of us. So our goal is probably going to be finished 5th in that. But that is all for today. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you have, make sure to slap a like on it. If you are new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.